Let's continue. So what I want you to do first is there's an ad group one here. You're going to rename that to, in this case, we're targeting Melbourne. So we're just going to have an acronym for Melbourne. And then we're going to say the service or the product. What are we pushing? So in this case, it's Invisalign treatment. Invisalign, always misspell that. But let's go through it. So we've got Melbourne Invisalign. The reason I want you to do this is so that in the future, when you have heaps of different ad groups and you're looking at your reports from an ad group level, it's easy to know what this ad group was about. Okay, and then it's easy to know the location. Okay, so next up, we've got the landing page. And just before this video, I deleted these, but it came up with like 20, 30 different keywords here that it suggested for me. Remove them. We don't want to go with those suggestions. And especially if Google is saying that you should run broad match, just ignore that. All right, if you don't know what that means, just it's okay. Let's keep going. So what you're going to do is go into tools and settings up the top, and you're going to right click and open keyword planner in a new tab. We're going to use Google Keyword Planner for our research. If you cannot find this setting, if it's not here, then just Google it. Then just Google Keyword Planner, and you'll come to a screen after you log in that looks like this. And so what we're going to do is find some ideas. Come up with some ideas around Invisalign. I've already preset the location to Melbourne. If in your case, wherever you're trying to target in the location, just select that city or surrounding suburbs. It's not that vital. As long as you've got just the main city, it's okay. You can make educated guesses around the volumes and stuff. But what we're going to do is come up with some keywords that we think people are typing in to find this page. And what I mean by that, not just find it, but they're finding it to take the next step in the cycle, because that's the whole purpose of this campaign, is to get more leads, right? And so we want to find leads based on intercepting traffic for people who are likely to take this next step. And what I mean by that, and I'll type that in, is that you wouldn't just type in Invisalign. If you just typed in Invisalign, and let's say you did it as a phrase match, a broad match, whatever you want, then what's going to happen is you're going to enter into different auctions in Google Ads for people saying, what is Invisalign? How does Invisalign work? What's the difference between Invisalign versus invisible braces and things like that? And obviously, if you show up an ad to that person when they've typed that in, there's like a very, very small chance that they're even going to click on you or even take action. And the reason for that is if they're just trying to find the difference between and they're not really ready to buy or take that next step, then you've just wasted your budget on that person. And so we're just trying to avoid that. So you need to be as granular as possible. In this case, we're going to say words like Invisalign near me, Invisalign dentist, Invisalign dentist Melbourne. And you might come up with just a few of these keywords. You don't have to be perfect. You don't have to be so very calculated. This is just thinking about words that you think people are going to type in to find this page, right? And it's not going to be perfect off the go. Like when you run this campaign and when you launch it, you're going to have so many new ideas based on what's happening, and you're never going to get it perfect right off the bat. And that's totally fine, okay? So what we're going to do is even this, right? We might run for these three keywords just to have a look. I'm going to minimize me here, and we're going to have a look at these keywords. So we've got Invisalign near me, 210 monthly searches in Melbourne. Just ignore this. You may not even see these. These are usually only accessed to more advanced Google Ads users, but it's okay. You don't really need these. Well, sometimes. So top of page, the bid low range. That's based out of all the auctions that are going in, the people who are entering into auctions are bidding this minimum range here. And this is the top range, the high range. And we're going to get into quality scores and different fancier jargon terms later. But what I want to do is keep this simple and short and sweet. So let's say, for example, before I do, get this Google extension here, Google Keyword Getter, highly recommend it, and I'll tell you why you want it. So let's go back into, so download that to your Google Chrome, and then go back to here, and you're going to select these keywords because we already thought, okay, these would be great keywords to go for. People who are typing this in have a high likelihood that they may be wanting to take that next step. And the idea here is it's going to come up with other keywords based on things you probably wouldn't have thought of, and you're going to go through and gloss through these. So you might go Invisalign dentist near me, great, I want that as well. Teeth straightening, nope, we don't want that. And the reason for that is even if Invisalign does do teeth straightening as one of its, the byproduct of it, you want to basically have a different ad group that's got teeth straightening keywords in it instead, so that it's all related to teeth straightening. And I'll go through that because the reason for it is there's something called quality scores, and I'll get through this now. I'll pause the video to show a source to explain it better. Okay, so I've written an article based on quality scores, and what quality scores are in simple terms is that if you have really highly relevant Google ads, so your ad is really relevant to what the person searches for, if they type in Invisalign Melbourne and your ad in the content says Invisalign Melbourne and the keyword you're bidding for is Invisalign Melbourne and on your landing page says keywords like Invisalign Melbourne, then usually there's a high likelihood that you're going to get a high quality score. So Google basically rates your ads on a scale. And if you do the right thing by Google, you're going to get percentages off your clicks. So for example, if you're bidding on Invisalign Melbourne, right, or Invisalign dentist near me, and the keyword range was between this and this, if you have your ads down pat and your landing page down pat, it's highly relevant to that search term, there's likelihood that you're going to get up to 50% discounts on your ads, right? It's insane. You can get discounts on your ads. A lot of people still don't know that. And so when you're actually going through your keyword ideas and your landing page and the way that you segment your ad groups and separate them, you want to make sure that you're highly relevant. So Invisalign, you want to keep it and bucket it in groups for just Invisalign. So have just Invisalign in me, Invisalign high intent keywords all in one bucket over here. And then you might create another ad group for teeth straightening and keywords around teeth straightening, and do some more keyword research around that. And perhaps, if you're lucky enough, send people to a landing page that's all about teeth straightening. Okay, does that make sense? So that's the whole purpose behind this, is you're trying to improve your quality scores as much as possible so that you can get more profitability out of your ads. Your cost per click is much lower than all the advertisers out there. And by a byproduct of that, if your quality scores are really high, Google awards you top spots on the search engine results page with your ads. And so that's the reason why we're only trying to find and get really granular on the exact keywords that we want. So we might go through the rest then. Invisalign braces, they're not exactly the same as Invisalign, so we're gonna skip that. And these are kind of things you want to do your research. If you're a marketing manager and you don't know the intricacies of the product or the service, you need to do your research. Okay, so let's go through it. Invisalign or for dentists near me, we might do that. Okay, so someone that's highly likely to book in that first client consult. Invisalign treatment near me, Invisalign braces near me. And some clients, in the case, they don't want their brand to have any connotations around cheap. And so then there might be more of a premium product line, and it's a good idea not to bid on like cheap keywords. And this brings me to negative keywords. So you might want to open up a notepad and think about words that you really don't want to be associated with or bid in auctions for. And I might think cheap. I don't want to bid on any auction that even mentions the word cheap in it. I might not want to bid on anything that means affordable, because that means that that patient may be more just a price shopper. They might just be, so there's no brand loyalty there whatsoever. In this case, it's probably a fine line, so I wouldn't do that, but I'm just giving an example. Cost near me, we might do cost, we might do, think of the negative keywords that we don't want. We don't want, and I noticed before when I was going through these, that there must be a dental login portal for Invisalign, because dentists actually find this login portal. And so I don't want to say anything that says login or login. That could be redundant, but I'll just want to do it to be safe. I might go through the rest of it and keep picking them out. But basically, I'll show you where to put these at the end of the, when you're launching the ads, you just put this in negative keywords. There's a section for it where you can put it in. But basically, you just want to go through the rest of these. And for the sake of this video, I'm going to try to make it as simple as possible. Ironically though, my Google keyword getter isn't showing on the bottom. So I might just want to refresh. Maybe it's just an issue with my current window. If it's not, I'm just going to show you another way to, I'll pause and get back to where I was. Okay, I'm back again. And so the extension must have glitched a little bit. I copied around a little bit, but it showed up here. So it'll say broad match, phrase match, and exact match. In worst case scenario, when the extension doesn't work, phrase match just literally means you're putting quotations on either side of the keyword. And so that means that you want to just enter into any auctions that this word, this phrase, is mentioned in any particular order, but it must include all four words in the search query. Whereas exact match, so this is a phrase match. This is an exact match, which means it's got to appear in this order of keywords the exact same way. If the auction has this in the keyword, so auction meaning if someone types this in as their query, it must contain this, and that's what an exact match is. Whereas broad match is just saying this, and it's got no kind of quotations around it. And so this just means you just want to enter into any auction whatsoever if it mentions Invisalign or around that particular topic, right? And you don't really want to go for that. Okay, so what we're going to do is go back to the getter tool and then click phrase match. So it's copied. We go back to the campaign. We're going to paste these in. So paste that in. So we've got the keywords that we want. Just ignore the right side here. And sometimes depending on your keyword, the keywords that you choose, it might say there's not enough volume or there's not enough estimates there, etc. In most cases, you can just ignore that. See down here, it says upgrade your keywords. Ignore that and also ignore this, right? Google is just trying to get you to spend more, and it adds to that ad wastage we talked about in the previous video. Now, in the next step, I'm going to talk about how to write high quality content that's persuasive using number psychology and power words. A lot of Google Ads people do not do this, and they do not set their pinning. So I'm going to go through some intricacies like this because I train my teams on this. Very, very vital. So I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.